You are watching the last time James Crumbley and his wife saw their son, Ethan.
Why? I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you.
Ethan killed four students and wounded seven other people at his Michigan high school in 2021. His mother, Jennifer, was found guilty on four counts of involuntary manslaughter. It's the first time ever that a parent has been held directly responsible for a mass shooting committed by their child. Now his father, James, is on trial, facing the same charges. He has pleaded not guilty. There is a lot of video that was entered into evidence in Jennifer's trial, and we fully expect that that is going to come into James' trial. Here are five key pieces of evidence. One, Ethan's experience with a gun. Prosecutors brought up during Jennifer's trial the way Ethan held a gun.
When I first saw it, I immediately said to others in the room that I thought that the shooter had been to a shooting range or had had training in firearms.
His posture, his demeanor, his stance, they realized that he had learned how to shoot from someone. And prosecutors are going to point the finger at James. In September, James took Ethan to a shooting range where they rented a 9mm pistol. A jury potentially is not going to look at this as incriminating, but prosecutors will build the building blocks of what they say is gross negligence. Two, who bought the gun? Ethan wanted a 9mm gun. He kept asking his parents, and they would tell him it's expensive. So on Black Friday, James said to Ethan, let's go back to the gun store and see if they're having any Black Friday sales. So they did. And here is the result. You are looking at the receipt for the 9mm Sig Sauer gun that was used for that mass shooting 4 days later. And there is nothing in the evidence that shows that James had any idea what he wanted to do with that gun. But James is the registered owner. And prosecutors are going to have that as Exhibit A because he was the one that owned it. It was his responsibility, the care, control, and custody of that gun. Three, a school meeting about a math worksheet. 4 days after getting that gun, James and Jennifer Crumbley were summoned to Oxford High School because Ethan was making disturbing drawings on a math worksheet. You see a gun, you see a figure, the thoughts won't stop, help me, blood everywhere. And he also says the world is dead. The counselor was really concerned that Ethan could harm himself, and the counselor wanted him to get mental health treatment as soon as possible. Now, the counselor didn't require that Ethan be taken out of school right then, and Ethan wanted to go back to class, and James and Jennifer Crumbley never told school officials that they had just gotten Ethan an early Christmas present of a gun. You can see Ethan Crumbley leaving that counselor's office. He's got his red backpack. Inside that red backpack is the 9mm gun that he just got 4 days ago. He goes to class and less than 2 hours later emerges from the bathroom and starts firing at his classmates. James and Jennifer left right behind him. Very short meeting, about 10, 11 minutes, and they go back to their jobs. Four, was the gun properly secured? Right after the mass shooting, James Crumbley got an emergency alert on his phone from Oxford High School. Active shooter. It occurred to him he needed to go home to see if that 9mm gun was still there. This is a picture that went into evidence in Jennifer Crumbley's trial. This is James and Jennifer's bed. The gun is gone and the bullet box is empty.
911, what's the location of your emergency?
Within minutes of this discovery, he calls 911.
I need an officer to come to my house right away, please.
He is frantic, he is emotional, and he turns his son in.
I think my son took the gun. I don't know if it's him. I don't know what's going on. I'm really freaking out.
Prosecutors will be able to really focus in on James' state of mind. They will argue that he knew his son was capable of perpetrating violence on others, and that's why he went home to see if that gun was there. But one thing is fact, and it helps the defense. James immediately called 911. He made sure law enforcement knew that his son could be the shooter. Right after the shooting, Ethan was arrested. He was taken down to the Oakland County Sheriff's Office, followed shortly after by his parents.
Right here, please.
What James says here about the gun could be very important for the defense.
It was hidden in our armoire, in the case, and bullets were hidden in a completely different spot.
We still don't know how Ethan got possession of that gun. It's a pivotal question, because if in fact the gun was hidden, but Ethan alone found that gun and took it to school, that places a lot of responsibility on Ethan because the parents did what they could. If the gun was out in the open, then it changes everything. 5. The arrest of James and Jennifer Crumbley. Police were looking for the Crumbleys after they failed to appear at their initial arraignment. After a manhunt, they were arrested at a friend's art studio where they were staying. There is evidence the Crumbleys had planned, though, to turn themselves in the very next day.
What's your name?
James.
James what?
Crumbley.
Prosecutors will argue this is evidence of consciousness of guilt. They wanted to flee the jurisdiction. They had everything they needed, and the Canadian border was pretty close. The defense will argue not at all. They were getting threats on their lives. They wanted to make sure they were safe, and media was surrounding their home. They had to find another place to stay. James Crumbley is innocent until proven guilty, but his defense attorney believes that he has already been found guilty because the Oxford community is still so filled with emotion. This trial will be in the same courtroom as Jennifer Crumbley's trial, and she was found guilty just a matter of weeks ago.